Hello friends, today we are seeing benzylic acid rearrangement. Myself Mr. Vikrant Dhamak, Assistant Professor from PRES College of Pharmacy for Women's, Chincholi, Sinnar, Nasik. Let's see firstly principle of this rearrangement. When this rearrangement, 1 to diketones are converted to alpha hydroxy carboxylic acid in basic conditions. We'll see general reaction now. So this is structure of benzyl, that is 1 to diketones having dual ketonic group, so it is said to be 1 to diketone. And under basic condition it converts to benzylic acid, that is alpha hydroxy carboxylic acid. So interesting to see over here is that it is also having aqueous acid. So why that aqueous acid has been added in this reaction, we'll see in mechanism. So in the first step of mechanism, nucleophile attacks carbonyl carbon, and this carbonyl carbon are electron deficient centers. So there are two electron deficient centers. Nucleophile attack one of them. Nucleophile is having three lone pair of electrons, and one it comes from an sodium after dissociation. Once it attacks, it breaks an pi bond between carbon and oxygen. In second step, there is 1-2 shift of phenyl group from first carbon to second carbon. For this, again, the carbonyl carbon breaks the pi bond and phenyl group is been shifted towards electron deficient carbon. And the lone pair on oxygen, it again creates a pi bond with the carbon. Third step is transfer of proton from hydroxyl group towards oxonium ion by giving away an electron towards an oxygen. In the next step, acidic proton is been added to oxonium ion. So as we discussed in general reaction also, why we are adding acid at the end. So from this mechanism you can understand that why we are adding acid at the end. And procedure has also been said that acidic water is been added at the end. And lastly we get a precipitated product, that is benzylic acid plus water. So it can be separated by simply filtration. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you.